right, good evening, everyone. Welcome to This Is Club Coca-Cola, broadcasting live on XM Radio. So, New York City, put your hands together, make some noise. Yeah, all right. And jazz festival featuring some of our great masters, as well as some emerging artists. And we've got a friend in the audience. He's a brilliant musician. We're always happy when he's either on the bandstand or just sitting at the bar hanging out. The great Joe Locke sitting at the bar, ladies and gentlemen. Give him some love. Right on, bro. And before we get started, just a couple of house rules. Take lots of photos, just no flash or video recording. But you can live tweet us on Twitter. Our hashtag is jazz.org, JAZZDOTORG. And of course, keep your conversations at the table to a quiet whisper so we can all enjoy the music together. All right? All right, y'all. Making their Dizzy's Club debut, an incredible composer and arranger. And he's bringing us some original music from three of his last albums. Put your hands together and welcome the great Ryan Cohen Sextet to the bandstand. Donald Edwards on the drums. Steve Wilson on the saxophone and the flute. John Ellis on saxophone and bass clarinet. Sipiagin on the trumpet and the fugal horn. Lorin Cohen on the bass. The great Ryan Cohen on piano. Enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. How's everybody feeling tonight? Yeah, well, we are just thrilled to be here tonight performing for you. Welcome to Dizzy's. We're going to be playing a mixture of music from my recordings, mostly my original music, but also some arrangements of some jazz standards as well. And we began with a tune, a composition of mine that was part of a larger work that I recorded a couple years ago called The River. It was a multi-movement suite inspired by a tour of Africa that I did in 2008. And each movement reflected a different part of the journey. We traveled throughout Uganda, Zimbabwe, Rwanda, and Congo. And the tune we just started out with this set was one of the first movements of the suite called Arrival, which was inspired by our first stop on the tour in Kigali, Rwanda, and all the nightlife and the activity and just sort of the vibe and energy that we felt. That was Arrival. We'd like to continue now with a tune of mine that was inspired, influenced by the great Thelonious Monk, and something that I call Monkin' Around. Thank you. Thank you very much. That was a piece that was made famous by Miles Davis's quintet, a piece by Victor Feldman, pianist, called Joshua. That's our arrangement of it. It was a pretty easy arrangement, actually. It's a very tricky tune that switches back and forth between meters, between 4/4 and 3/4. I've always had a tricky time playing that tune when I was learning it many years ago, and just looking for a new way to play it, so I just switched the threes and the fours, and it's pretty simple, and I was done. It was like, it's got a new arrangement, but it's a little different, and it's a lot of fun to play. We'd like to continue now with another piece of music that was from The River, and this next piece was inspired by a young musician that I met in Kigali, Rwanda. And one thing that made the tour that we were on very special was that it wasn't just a performance tour where we went around and played concerts. It was really a cultural outreach tour. It was about connecting with the people in the different places that we visited, and not only them hearing us, but us hearing them, and them playing with us, and us playing with these different musicians. And one thing that was really amazing is we met a lot of musicians who didn't have a lot of opportunity. We visited some very poor areas that were ravaged by war, and particularly in Rwanda, the whole country was, you know, at the time, this was almost 8 years ago, it was still recovering from the genocide. It was doing well, but it was still, you know, very present in their history. And I met this young piano player, and it was typical of young people from that area that their education stopped, you know, when the genocide happened. So particularly young people, their education, you know, could have stopped any time from, you know, very young to 10 years old to and their, you know, teenagers. And they didn't have the opportunity to learn more. So we would meet these talented musicians that if they were anywhere else that had the opportunity to have resources of recordings or sheet music or teachers or anything, they would do exceptionally well. But it was talent in the rawest element. And I met this one young piano player in Rwanda. We were giving a jam. We were having a jam session where we were playing with the young musicians. And this particular musician, he knew one tune. He knew the tune Autumn Leaves. So we were playing on this tune, just going around, playing it over and over, and trading ideas. And I realized pretty quickly that he can basically hear anything that I was playing. I would start out very simply, playing one or two notes, you know, or just some simple chord voicings. But very shortly, he was hearing most sophisticated chords I could play on the piano and rhythms, and I was incredibly inspired by these musicians' talent and love of the music. Music was so important to the people in these areas, and just the incredible heart and just the importance of studying it and the resilience. It really made a big impact on me. So I dedicated this next piece that was from The River to this young musician. It's named after him, and it's titled Brother Fifi. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. That was Duke Ellington's Don't You Know I Care. And before that, we played an original composition of mine entitled Another Look. And we have one more tune to play for you this set. Before we do that, I want to introduce these incredible musicians who I feel very, very fortunate to have with me tonight. Some of the best improvisers, instrumentalists you're going to hear anywhere, and band leaders and composers in their own right. And I'm thrilled to have them here playing my music. First, on the bass clarinet, tenor saxophone, and soprano saxophone, Mr. John Ellis. On trumpet and flugelhorn, Mr. Alex Sipiagin. On the alto saxophone, soprano saxophone, and flute is a man who's I've wanted to play with for many years, and who has inspired me with his own bands and his own and his assignment on many different recordings that have influenced me over the years. The great Steve Wilson. Our bassist, wonderful bassist and composer, Mr. Lorin Cohen. And a super swinging drummer, our super swinger, super swinging drummer. You try and say that. Also a great composer, studio owner, Renaissance man, Donald Edwards on the drums. Donald Edwards. Also like to again acknowledge a couple great musicians who are in the house that are good friends. First, he was mentioned earlier, but I want to mention him again. One of the premier vibraphonists in the world, an artist who I've been very fortunate to collaborate with for the last few years. Mr. Joe Locke is in the house. Thank you for coming, Joe. And also a very, very special bassist who used to live in Chicago and that I played with for many years in Chicago and then still play with him. When he comes to town or if I'm in New York, absolutely incredible bassist who was with Ahmad Jamal's iconic trio for 30 years. Mr. James Kamak is in the house. Thank you, James, for being here. We are going to conclude with a tune of mine that I recorded on a record called One Sky several years ago on the Motema label. And this is called Checkmate. Checkmate. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Donald Edwards on the drums. Lorin Cohen, bass. John Ellis, saxophones, bass clarinet. Alex Sipiagin, trumpet and flugelhorn. Steve Wilson, saxophone and flute. Here's truly Ryan Cohen on piano. Thank you very much. We're going to take a break. We'll be back.
I say it one more time for the Ryan Cohen Sextet, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for coming out. And if you'd like to take the music home with you, we will have CDs for sale right here next to the piano. Ryan's got one more set. Stick around if you can. And our Generations in Jazz Festival continues. Thanks again for coming to Dizzy's. One more time. Let's hear it for the band. We'll see you all very soon. Good night. All right, good evening, everyone. Welcome to Dizzy's Club Coca-Cola. How you doing? Ooh, all right, let's try that one more time. Welcome to Dizzy's Club Coca-Cola. How you doing? Yeah, there it goes. All right, nice. Thank you all for coming out. We continue with our Generations in Jazz Festival tonight with some incredible musicians coming to the stage. Before they do, please remember, take lots of photos, just no flash or video recording. Of course, if we keep our conversations at the table to a quiet whisper, we can all enjoy the music together. But, you know, when you all hear something you like, make some noise, all right? There we go, just like that. Put your hands together and give a warm welcome to the Ryan Cohen Sextet, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Welcome to Dizzy's. How's everybody feeling tonight? Yeah? We're feeling wonderful. We are just absolutely thrilled to be here playing for you. We are going to be playing you a mix of mostly my original music and some arrangements of a couple jazz standards as well from my last few recordings. And we began with a composition of mine that was part of a larger work that I recorded on a record a couple years ago. The piece, the larger piece, was called The River. And it was a multi-movement suite based, inspired by a tour of Africa that I did in 2008. We visited Rwanda, Congo, Uganda, and Zimbabwe. It was an amazing, tour, so much so that it influenced me to write this large work. It was about an hour long, and each movement of the work was sort of a picture, an oral picture of a different stop along the journey. And the tune we just played was entitled Arrival from that larger suite, and it depicts our first stop in Africa in Rwanda, in Kigali, Rwanda, and just the amazing energy and nightlife and activity of the people and in the land and just the culture. It was really remarkable. And we'd like to continue now with another composition of mine that I originally had under a different title that I was, at the time I was listening a lot to the late great pianist Mulgrew Miller. And yeah, Mulgrew. Yeah. Mulgrew had a big influence on my playing and my composing. And for those of you that are not familiar with him, he passed away a couple years ago, much before his time. And just one thing that I think influenced me and my music, and I think with everybody he played for, he had an amazing ability to translate warmth and just great feeling and humanity in everything he played. Regardless, he was a master of the piano. He was a pianist. He was a pianist, someone who piano players go to learn from in the language of jazz, bebop, anything he played. All technical, harmonic, whatever he played, super sophisticated, that jazz musicians are studying his music. But his message that came through was an amazing warmth and feeling. And it's a very rare thing, and something that all musicians and all people that were lucky to hear him were left with. And at the time, I was just composing several different pieces of music, and I composed this next piece that we're going to play for you. And I didn't even realize that I wasn't trying to write something in the style of, but it just his influence was so great on me that it was sort of, he left that mark on this piece of music. And then since he's passed, I retitled it, and I call this Groove's Groove for Mulgrew Miller. Thank you. Thank you very much. That was a piece that Miles Davis's quintet made famous, something written by Victor Feldman, the pianist Victor Feldman, called Joshua. That's our version of it. And we'd like to continue now with another piece that was from The River. And this movement was inspired by a young musician that I met in Kigali, Rwanda. And what was really special about the tour, this particular tour that we were on, that we spent a month through Africa, was that it was the idea of the tour was cultural exchange. It wasn't just where we were just playing concerts and we didn't really interact with the folks that we met. We were in some pretty rural places that not only were they not familiar with jazz, but often they had never seen Americans, and their perception of Americans and America was all through a propaganda, a government-fed propaganda of the people. And so it was, and vice versa. So it was a really amazing experience to connect with the musicians that we encountered. And what was really special was that we met so many young musicians that had just the rawest natural element of talent. And a lot of places we were at, they had no resources at all. There was no money. There was no opportunity for education. And in particular, in this area of Kigali, Rwanda, where we were at, which was still very affected, the whole country was still recovering from the genocide, it was common for young people, it was basically the case for everybody, that when the genocide happened, education systems stopped. So there were a lot of young people that they might have stopped their education at a very young age and they didn't have a chance to go to school, but they were incredibly talented. And we met this one piano player who we were playing a jam session and interacting with a lot of local musicians. And we were playing with them. We were playing on a jazz standard, and this musician knew one standard. He happened to know Autumn Leaves. So we were just going around playing Autumn Leaves over and over, and I would show him some very simple things on the piano, thinking, I'll just show him some simple things. We don't really have much time to get deep into this, but I realized quickly that whatever I played, he was playing it back immediately. So it started out with a couple, single notes, two notes together. Very soon, I could play anything on the piano. He could play it right back. And these young people, if they had the opportunity that young people have in this country in general, just being around the music, just access to a recording, these people have nothing. These people, these young musicians would be incredible and just be the top musicians around anywhere in the world. So I was so moved by the spirit of this young musician, his dedication and the desire to learn the music. Music was so important in these communities. And it was a very big learning experience for me of what music, how important music is. And it really taught me a lot of lessons. And this young player, I was so moved by his resilience and his desire to learn, an incredible talent, incredible spirituality and heart, that I dedicated this to him. And it's named after him. This is Brother Fifi. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'd like to continue now with a composition of mine that was from a record. This is from the record with the same title, Amotima, and this is called Another Look.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We have one more tune we'd like to play for you before we say goodnight. First, I want to introduce these incredible musicians who I feel very, very fortunate to have with me tonight. These, as far as I'm concerned, are some of the best improvisers and instrumentalists anywhere, all band leaders and great composers in their own right, and I'm honored to have them here playing my music with me. First, how about a hand for the wonderful Mr. Donald Edwards on the drums. Donald Edwards. Our bassist is Lorin Cohen. Lorin Cohen. On the saxophones and bass clarinet, Mr. John Ellis. Mr. Alex Sipiagin is playing the trumpet and the flugelhorn, Mr. Alex Sipiagin. And an artist whose music has inspired me and influenced me for many years, and I've been wanting to play with him for a long time, playing saxophones and flute, the great Mr. Steve Wilson. I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank the staff and everybody at Dizzy's Club Coca-Cola and Jazz at Lincoln Center for having us. It's really special to play in this incredible venue, and thank you very much, Dizzy's. Thank you, Jazz Lincoln Center, for this really special club. Thank you for having us. And to all of you, we're really grateful you joined us this evening, and we hope you'll keep in touch. Follow where we're playing. You can check it out at ryancohen.com, and we hope to see you again. We are going to conclude our evening with an original composition of mine, which is from a record that I did that came out in 2007 on the Motema label, and this is called Checkmate. Checkmate. We'll be right back. Thank you very much. Donald Edwards. Donald Edwards on the drums. Lorin Cohen on the bass. Mr. John Ellis on the saxophones and bass clarinet. Alex Sipiagin on the trumpet and flugelhorn. Mr. Steve Wilson on the saxophones and flute. Yours truly, Ryan Cohen on piano. Thank you all very much for being here. Hope to see you again real soon. Have a good night.
Let's say it one more time for the Ryan Cohen Sextet, ladies and gentlemen. All right, and we will have CDs for sale, piano side of the stage. We've got one more band coming to this bandstand in probably another 10 minutes, so stick around. Sammy Miller and his congregation are up next. Let's hear it for Ryan Cohen and these cats one more time, y'all. Thank you all for coming to Disney. Stick around. We got one more show.